Hello students. Now in our today's lecture we are going to talk about the shell, subshell and orbitals. We all have heard about the shells from class 9 that the shells are the orbits in which the electrons are moving. We used to represent it with the help of a circular line or orbit. Now there are various different terms that have arisen when we have moved with the Bohr's model, the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, the de Broglie equation. Now, with these new concepts, we are going to talk about shell, subshell and orbitals in the today's lecture. So, what are shells? Shells or orbits? These are the circular path around the nucleus of an atom along which the electron travels or traverses. So, according to the Bohr model, the shells are represented by the principal quantum number, as he has given in one of his postulates that the shells are represented by the integer and is given the term principal quantum number, and n can have the value 1, 2, 3, 4, or we used to call them as KLMN. The energy of these shells were also calculated by Bohr, their angular momentum. But later on, with the moving of the de Broglie equation, the Heisenberg, the orbit concept has got not so much of the value, and it has later on converted into the subshell and the orbital concept. So what are subshells? So each shell consists of one or more of the subshells in it. The term that we used to say shells is now each shell consists of a shell or subshells which can be one or two or more in number. We used to talk about the four subshells. These are designated as S, P, D and F. And the first shell, that is the first shell, K shell, consists of only one subshell which is given the name S, small s. We used to show the subshell always by a small alphabet. Now in the second shell there are the two subshells S and P. In the third shell there are the three subshells S, P and D. And in the fourth shell there are four subshells S, P, D and F. So first we got to know about the shells. These are the fixed orbit. Then the subshells which are present inside the shell. And now the third term, that is the orbital, which is one of the most important term when we are moving in the quantum mechanics. So now the term orbitals. When we talk about the orbitals, the atomic orbital is the space where the probability of finding an electron is highest. Where there is maximum probability of finding the electron, it is given by the term orbital, and each subshell consists of orbitals in it. So first we came to know that atom is having the orbits. The orbits is having the subshells. And now the other thing, the subshells are again having the orbitals present in it. So it is going one in one, that is the part including in the other part. It is going like that. So atom has orbits, orbit has subshells, subshells has orbitals. So now when we are talking about the orbitals, the S subshell consists of only one orbital. The P subshell is having the three orbitals, which are given the name Px, Py and Pz according to the directions in which it is lying. And then the D subshell, which consists of the five orbitals. Then come the time of the F subshell, which consists of the seven orbitals. So atom has orbits, orbits has subshells, and the subshells are having the orbitals in it. As you know, students, that previously we used to give KLMN, the principal quantum number N, as we used to call them as KLMN, 1, 2, 3 or 4. Similarly, let us see that what the notations we are having for S, P, D and F. So student, for S subshell, the S subshell we are having the numeric representation of 0. For P, it is 1. For D, it is 2. And for F, it is 3. So remember how they are represented by a number, mathematical number. So S by 0, P by 1, D by 2 and F by 3. And the number of parts in each of these subshell are, in case of S, it is only the 1. In case of P, it is 3. In case of D, it is 5. The 5 parts are there in the D subshell. And in case of F, there are the 7 orbitals present in it. So how they are represented in a numeric way and how many parts are associated in each subshell has to be remembered each time when we are going to give the electronic configuration also. So what we have learned till now, what are shells, what are subshells and what are the orbitals. So all of these are included one inside the other. Now let us come to the other topic, the shapes of atomic orbital. As you know, student, the atomic orbitals are present in the subshells, and subshells are given the name sp, d, and f. And these sp, d, and f are further divided into their subparts, that is the atomic orbital. Now, the shapes of the atomic orbital is found by finding the probability, which is represented by psi square, of the electron in that orbital and at different points around the nucleus. So the probability of finding the electron is represented by different points around the nucleus and is calculated by the density of these points. So the shape of electron cloud, the electron cloud, the probability cloud where the electron is assumed to be present, gives us the shape of these atomic orbital. Now some of the orbitals are found to have a region of space within which the probability is zero. So there is also the space where the probability is zero, and this point is known as the node. So node is the point where the probability of finding the electron is zero. So these nodes are of two types. We call them as spherical or radial nodes, and the other are known as the planar or angular nodes. Now let us come one by one to the different shapes of the orbital. The first is the s orbital. So s are the spherical in nature. You can see that one s very small in size, spherical but small. Now when we talk about the 2s, it is a little bit larger than 1s, but still it is spherical, and then compare with the 3s. So the s orbital is spherical in shape. Now some few more important points about the s orbital are: the probability of finding the electron is in s orbital is found to be identical in all the directions around the nucleus, that is at equal distance from the nucleus. So hence the s orbital is spherical in shape. So all the shapes are given the shapes are given the name according to the probability of finding these electrons. As in case of the s orbital, the probability is same on all the sides of the nucleus, so it is spherical in shape. But different s orbitals are having the different shapes, different energies. Different s orbitals are having different energies. As we can say that 1s is having less energy as compared to 2s, as compared to 3s. And we also know this from the Bohr energy or level calculation diagram and the formula, that energy, as we move away the nucleus, the energy of the orbit goes on increasing. But different s orbital differ in energy and number of nodes also. So in case of 1s, there is no node, there is no point where there is the probability of finding the electron is zero. But when we talk about the 2s orbital, so let us draw it. Let us think that it is the electron cloud diagram and the boundary level also. So it is 1s, and this is the point for 2s. This is the probability curve for the 2s. So we can see that in between 1s and 2s, that is in between 1s and 2s orbital, it is 1s, it is 2s, there is presence of one node, the blank space. This is space, this is the node. So what you can see that in between 1s and 2s, there is presence of one node. So what about the 3s? When we talk about 3s, then there will be one cloud for 1s, then the other electronic cloud for the 2s. You can see that it is spherical. Okay, but when we talk about the 3s, this cloud is again a bigger one, and then we will find how many nodes are there. We can easily see that among 1s, 2s, and 3s, the total number of nodes are 1 and 2. So two nodes are present when we talk about the 3s orbital. So this is about the calculation of nodes also and the diagram of s orbital. Now let us come to the shapes of the p orbitals. So students, the p orbitals are three in number. They are px, py, and pz. Px, py, and pz. And you can see that in case of px, py, and pz, there are the two lobes present. And when we are talking about the px, it is on the x-axis. When we are talking about py, it is on the y-axis. And when we are talking about pz, it is on the z-axis. The shape of the p orbital is known as dumbbell shape. It is known as the dumbbell shape. And since these three p orbitals are lying, are having the same energy, they are present in the same energy shell. So the energy of these three p, if they are belonging to the same shell, are equal. So they are given another name, that is the degenerate orbitals. So degenerate orbitals are those orbitals which are lying in the same energy level as in case of p. All the three p are belonging to the second shell. Similarly, it can belong to the third shell. So those p orbital which are belonging to the same shell are considered as the degenerate orbitals. Now 2p has no node, 3p has one node, and 4p has two nodes. So how this number is calculated? So as we know that the nodes are of two types, that is the spherical and the angular nodes. So when we talk about the spherical nodes, as we have told you in the beginning, the nodes are of two types, the spherical and the angular. So when we talk about the spherical nodes, how to calculate the spherical nodes? The formula of the spherical nodes is n minus l minus 1. What is n? It is the principal quantum number. What is l? It is the azimuthal quantum number. And how you calculate the angular quantum number? The angular nodes, it is equal to the l, that is the azimuthal number. So when we talk about the 2p, so in case of 2p, the spherical nodes is equal to n minus l minus 1. N, it is 2, minus the number of p, spdf, we know that the p is represented by 1, minus 1 is equal to 0. So the spherical node in case of 2p orbital is 0. But what about the angular node? The angular node is equal to the azimuthal quantum number. So in case of 2p, the spherical node is 0, but the angular node is going to be 1. So 2p has no spherical node. When we talk about 3p, it will be having the 1. That is 3 minus 1 minus 1. And when we talk about the 4p, then it is going to have the two nodes. So we will calculate separately the spherical nodes, the angular nodes, and then we will calculate the total number of nodes present in it. Now it's time to come to the d orbital, the d orbital. So the total number of d orbitals associated are 5. There are total 5 d orbitals, 5 in number. It is 5 in number. We can see the different shapes of the d orbitals. There are 5 d orbitals, and depending on the axis along which or in between these lobes are lying, they are given the different names. For example, you can see in case of dxy, the total 4 lobes are present in between the x and y axis, so it is called dxy. Then xz, again between, in between the x and z axis, and yz, in between the y and z axis. But when we talk about the dz, x square minus y square, it is lying on the axis. They are lying on x and y. Now dz square is a little bit different. The shape of dz square is a donut shape, and it is having only 2 lobes. But for all the other, you can see that there are the total number of lobes are 4. Now, one very important point here, the d orbital has 2 nodal plane. You can see that there are the 2 nodal plane. If we are talking about xy, the 2 nodal plane can be easily seen. But in case of dz square, it is very, very important, because it is different from all the other d. In case of z square, the shape is different. In case of dz square, there is only 1 nodal plane. So the shapes of d orbital, the number of nodal plane, all have to be calculated here. Now let us come about the formulas of the nodes that we are talking about. So the number of the spherical nodes is always given by n minus l minus 1, where n is equal to principal quantum number, that is equal to the number of the shell, and l is equal to azimuthal quantum number. We can also say that l can be, if it is s, we put 0, if it is p, then we put 1. For d, we used to say 2, and for f, we used to say 3. Then for n minus l minus 1, the n is the principal quantum number and l is azimuthal. Then the number of the spherical nodes will be n minus l minus 1, and the number of the angular nodes is simply calculated by using the name of the subshell. So let us see an example of 2p as we have given in the beginning. In case of 2p, the number of spherical nodes is equal to n minus l minus 1. n is 2. The number for p is 1. So the total number of spherical nodes are 0. But when we talk about the angular nodes or azimuthal nodes, so azimuthal nodes is equal to l. And what is the value of p here? The p is 1. So spherical nodes are 0, angular nodes are 1. So the total number of nodes become total nodes in case of 2p is 1. Okay, now let us take one more example of this type. Let us take the example of 3p. Now in case of 3p, spherical nodes equal to n minus l minus 1, 3 minus p. The value of p is 1, minus 1, that is 1. What about in case of spherical, that is 3 minus 1 minus 1. Okay, now in case of the angular node is equal to the azimuthal quantum number L. Now in case of P it is 1. So the total number of nodes in case of 3P becomes 2. Or we can directly calculate the total number of nodes as total number of nodes is equal to N minus 1 or 3 minus 1, that is 2. So you can calculate in either of the way how the nodes are calculated. Now the last thing, that is the two marker difference in a used to be a part of our exam paper, is the difference between the orbit and the orbital. Now let us see what is the difference between the orbit and the orbital. So orbits represent the planar motion of the electron, that is a two-dimensional motion. But when we talk about the orbital, we are considering the three-dimensional motion of the electron around the nucleus. From the very beginning, we are talking about orbits. Orbits are always circular in shape. But when we talk about the orbital, we have just seen S is spherical, P is dumbbell, D is clover leaf, donut. Different shapes are associated with the different orbitals. Now, it is a well-defined path in case of orbits. When we are talking about the orbits, it is a well-defined path that revolving electrons follow around the nucleus. But when we talk about the orbital, in case of the orbital, it is simply a region of space around the nucleus where the electron is present. So now the fourth point. In case of orbit, the orbit theory does not satisfy the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. We have talked about this in Heisenberg uncertainty principle also. But the orbital concept is given according to the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Now orbit, when we have to calculate the number of electrons in the orbit or a shell, we used to put the formula as 2n square. The number of electrons are calculated as 2n square, where n is the number of the shell, the principal quantum number. But when we talk about the orbital, only 2 electrons can be present in an orbital. Now the last point, the planar motion of electron, that is in the orbit, the orbits are represented as KLMN 1, 2, 3, 4. But when we talk about the orbital, they are given the term S, P, D and F. As they are associated with the three-dimensional motion, they are given different names and always by a small alphabet, that is S, P, D and F. So in today's lecture, we have gone through the water shell, water subshell, the different orbitals, the shapes of orbital and also the difference between the orbit and orbital. So go through the topic very thoroughly, prepare your notes. Until then, revise the things. That's all for today. We will meet in the other lecture now.